Hi friends, Mickey from Figma here, and today we're going to talk about the Suggest Auto Layout feature in Figma. So let's go. Let's begin by taking a look at this frame here. You'll notice that we have a frame and we have a few objects inside of it. This text and these icons and these lines are all just free floating in this frame. Now I have a duplicate of that frame here, and if we take a look at this card, you can see that we have the album icon, name, dividers, and all of these elements inside. Let's say I want to apply auto layout so I can have better control of the responsiveness of this card. I'm going to select the card and press Shift A. Now with Shift A applied, you'll notice that it's been applied as a wrap object. Things aren't necessarily working the way that I expect it to. That is where the new feature Suggest Auto Layout comes in. Here, I'm going to take this same card, I'm going to right click, I'm going to come down here to More Layout Options and choose Suggest Auto Layout. The shortcut key for that is going to be Control Shift A. Let's try that. Control Shift A. We've now have four new auto layout frames created. Let's take a look at the layers panel. I need to move myself out the way. So yeah, let's take a look at the layers panel right here. You'll notice some little blue dots. Those little blue dots are telling me what new auto layout frames have been created. Now let's take a look at this card. I can extend it and I can shrink it down. And you notice that this rectangle here is going to fill container. These text layers are filling container. These icons are sitting to the right, and I can add in additional text. That text will extend, and we'll see that this icon is going to align center. Now, you can make adjustments here, so let's double click in. I can have that icon set to the top alignment of that auto layout frame, but this is looking pretty good. So I'm going to hit undo a bunch of times, and let's take a look at that one more time. I'm going to hit undo all the way back till our card is its normal self, just a frame with some elements inside. I'm going to select that one more time and press Control Shift A. When I press Control Shift A, four new auto layout frames created, and you can see each of those frames inside to easily make this responsive. How cool is that? Now let's make that from scratch. I'm going to draw in a rectangle. I'm going to type in, let's say a number. So I'm going to do 01. Let's snap that to the left. I'm going to hold down the Option key, Alt key if you're on Windows, to make a duplicate. And I'm going to put in a title. I'm going to say graphic design. I'm going to put that over here to the right. Let's extend that out along the way. Next, I'm going to hit the T key. I'm going to draw out a text field, and I'm going to press Command K and type in rewrite this. We're going to say write a sentence about graphic design. And that's going to use our rewrite AI feature to write a simple sentence about graphic design. If the text field isn't auto height, you can just extend it down, double click on it, and that will make that text field auto height. Let's lose the bold and go back to regular text, and let's make this text just a little smaller. I have these elements set up. Now let's create a frame around them. I'm going to press the F key, drag and extend over this space. You can see we have that frame. I'm going to round out those corners. Let's set those round corners to be about 12. Now they're inside of the frame. Let's go ahead and choose Suggest Auto Layout. With Suggest Auto Layout applied, we can see that we now have this new frame here, and all the other text is there. As I add in new text, it will extend the height of this card. And if I was to extend the width of this card, you can see that it is maintaining its responsiveness there. But wait, folks, I got one more trick up my sleeve. Let's say I take this and I want to have more of a repeating element. I can select it. I'm going to hold down the Option key, Alt key if you're on Windows, drag and click and have a second one. Let's take those two cards, place them inside of a single auto layout frame. I'm going to press Shift A. And now that that auto layout has been added, you're going to notice this little option right here. This is going to be our duplicator. It's going to duplicate those cards. So as I'm dragging, it's duplicating more cards there. If you want different content for each card, I can hit Command Return and use the Replace Content option. And you'll see here that every one of my cards, so graphic design, product design, UI UX design, motion graphics design, web design, they're all there and working. So you can see I can extend this wide and I can decrease that width, and all of those elements are now responsive. How cool is that? Hopefully you found that helpful. And as always, happy designing. Wait, one more thing. Let's say here we have a bunch of nested auto layout frames, and maybe we want to rename those frames. I'm going to press Command K, Control K if you're on Windows, and type in rename layers. Because we have all of those elements there, we want them to be properly named. We can see them being named in real time. I think that looks great. So we have not only that, but also our layers named. Now, if auto layout isn't your deal, let's say you don't like the auto layout, you want it broken down, you would rather have static frames, you just have that one teammate who just doesn't like auto layout, I can right click, come over here to more layout options, and choose the option remove auto layout. I'm going to do that. And it's removed all auto layout from 13 frames. And you'll see here when I extend that main container, it's no longer has auto layout applied. Quickly to recap, we covered suggest auto layout. We covered rewrite this. We covered duplicate content and replace content. We also covered remove all auto layout. So those are just some of the new features that you can find in Figma. Hopefully you found this tutorial helpful. And as always, happy designing.